And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the St. Louis Cardinals and the Detroit Tigers. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. All right, just about set to go. And taking the ball for Detroit, Kenta Maeda.
Well, there are going to be a lot of balls in play because of the ground ball rate. Important that the defense stays engaged in the game. I think it's critical tempo is there. If you work quickly, it helps the fielders behind you to stay engaged, to make those plays, and help you get through the innings.
Pitch lifted in the air, right center field. Meadows on the move, no trouble here, puts it away for the out, and there's one away. And let's take a look at the lineup. Wilson Contreras now up to the plate. This is a guy who is very highly regarded defensively. Fun to watch him control stuff behind the plate. Good game caller, good at framing, but it's that big arm that really stands out. That misses the zone. 2-1.
When you got a catcher like this guy with a big arm like that behind the plate, it really shuts down the running game.
And another ball.
Well, I'll say this, as a former position player and base stealer, when you come into a game and you've got a guy like this behind the dish with a big arm, you really have to change your approach. Can't try to steal because you'll get thrown out. Maybe get a little bigger lead, be aggressive on the secondary, but this type of guy shuts the running game down.
There's a swing and a drive. And it jumps the wall in foul territory for an automatic double.
That's such a frustrating play for an outfielder. You know you should make this play, but you never really had a chance because of the bad angle. What should have been an out turned out to be a double.
Man at second with one away. And stepping in for the Cardinals, Lars Nootbaar. Inside corner, and that's called a strike. Contreras, the runner at second with one away. Got him looking. Two down.
Most guys are very aggressive when they see the stakes out there on the base paths and can't understand why he wasn't ready to swing the bat. You've got to be ready to swing the bat in a situation like that with the go-ahead run in scoring position.
Here's Nolan Arenado. Right through there for a strike. Two outs. Baez whips it to first. And they get Arenado for the out. And that is that. So one left for the Cardinals. The Tigers coming up. No score. You're watching Major League Baseball on The Show. Back here in Detroit. And pitching in this game, Miles Michaelis.
Well, he comes at hitters with a 5-pitch mix, so for him, it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on one or two pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working. But if he can control 4 or even 5 of those offerings, look out, hitters. It's going to be a tough day. He's really going to be able to keep those guys off balance.
Swing and he breaks his bat, and it's a foul ball. And the pitch. Bows it off, still 1-2. In the air, left field, Donovan. Sizing this one up, hauls it in for the out. Let's take a check of the Tigers lineup. Here's Mark Canna. One out, base is empty. Ball. And now 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
And three another
balls,
ball.
One strike.
And there's a foul ball. One down, base is empty. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Batting third.
So now the DH spot, Kerry Carpenter. And a pitch. There goes the runner. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Brings it in.
Batting fourth. The first base.
And next up for the Tigers, Spencer Torkelson. Ground ball up the middle, that's a base hit. Throw stops the lead runner at second, two on and two out.
Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield.
Matt Vierling will hit next. That one finds the zone, and it's 1-2. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. Got him. Third out.
Sometimes he wears the emotion on the sleeve, but that's okay as long as he's getting results. And right there, thrilled with the punch out to get out of a jam.
Back at Comerica Park, and here's Paul Goldschmidt.
The first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
And a pitch. And that one fouled off. The pitch. And a swing and a miss. And there's one down.
Well, that slider down and away, it's just kind of a slow death. The two strikes you're looking to protect, and halfway to the plate, you know you've committed, and you know you're going to have no chance of touching it. Tell you what, sometimes you just have to tip your cap.
Now it's the right fielder, Jordan Walker. The wind of the pitch.
That's ball three. Three balls, one strike.
Kicks and deals. Right back to him on the mound.
Got him.
Fires over to first. Two up, that, two down on the top of the second.
The shortstop, Mason Wynn.
Mason Wynn. Next up for the Cardinals. Singh, you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays. Just missed.
And because of that big power arm, he's able to play a little bit deeper, make throws from the outfield grass all the way across the diamond, and still get a pretty good runner. That's impressive.
They'll score here in the second. Out towards right center field. Green grabs it on the run. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Bottom of the second. Here's the second baseman, Colt Keith.
The second baseman.
Swing and a miss as he was out front.
One ball, two strikes.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. The pitch. That one the other way. Win. Slings it across. That's one out in the bottom of the second. And next to hit for Detroit, Parker Meadows. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. Pitch misses. Now two balls and a strike.
Well, this guy's definitely a plus runner, but what I love about him is that he goes all out every single time, never takes a break. It's guys like that, even though they don't have the elite speed, the fact that they're consistent with it, they make moves on the base paths.
Now it's Javier Baez. Two outs, base is empty. Good eye in that spot. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Three up, three down. Inning over. Tigers fail to make any noise. We'll move to the third with no score. On to the third inning. Here's Nolan Gorman.
The second base.
He provides a surprising amount of pop from the second base position.
Listen, that's not something to take lightly. Getting that kind of production from the guys up the middle, it's not a strength of most lineups.
Ball two.
Good eye right there. And what does that do for a team when you get power from unexpected spots like that?
When you're in the dugout and you see a guy come up big like that that you don't necessarily expect it, it just energizes that entire team.
On the ground right side, and it goes just foul. And it's popped out.
That swing right there tells me he's seeing the ball pretty well. I know it didn't produce a hit, but he made solid contact, and that's all you're looking to do anytime you're at the plate.
Now batting Michael Ciani. Here's a 1-1. And that one is lifted in the air. Meadows moving in on this one. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two away. Brendan Donovan. Next up for the Cardinals. Top of the third. No score. Strike two. Gets a piece and stays alive. And he deals. In the air, right field. Brings it in for the third out. Home half of the third coming up. No score. And we're back. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's the catcher, Jake Rogers. Right-hander kicks, deals.
That's ball two.
A wind and a pitch. That one fouled off, 2-2. And the righty deals. Slider misses outside. Swings and misses on the fastball up in the zone for the strikeout.
That was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Back to the top of the Detroit order. Here's Riley Green. On the line, base hit. Just kind of sliced that one into center.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm front side, and the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
Next to hit, Mark Canna. Righty delivers. Fouled off. He was late. The 1-2. Fights it off, he'll see another. Inside, almost got him.
Two balls, two strikes.
Kicks and fires. And that's outside. Full count now. Payoff pitch goes down looking for the strikeout. Not sure about that call. Pitcher might have gotten a friendly strike three.
Wow, that's a tough call for the hitter, but the pitcher will take that all day long. Not quite in the strike zone, but he found a spot that the umpire is going to, at least for now, allow him to get that call. So hitters are going to have to make an adjustment, but pitchers are going to learn from those things and really try to exploit them if they can. 3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Left-hand batter waits. Three. Swing and a miss, and that is that. Tigers leave one, still no score. And welcome back to the ballpark. John Ciambi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Wilson Contreras. One one now.
And this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
Righty to the plate. That one just misses. The pitch. Throw on to Torkelson. Leadoff hitter retired in the fourth.
He's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Lars Nootbaar getting ready to hit. And a pitch. And that should be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. And that's a double.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. Comes a thing of beauty. He may have been a little behind the pitch, but by getting that barrel into the hitting zone early on in his swing, he was able to meet it and still shoot a line drive down the line and left. Runner in scoring position now, and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
Here's Nolan Arenado. Up the middle. Baez fires over to first. And they get Arenado for the out.
Not a bad outcome in that spot. The runner moves up to third, and now they have a chance to drive in the go-ahead run. It's not a knock, but at the end of the day, it's a good at-bat.
Now it's Goldschmidt up to the plate. Here's a 1-1. Just off the inside edge. Base hit center field. And they'll score first. It's 1-0.
His confidence level is so high. Really nice job of coming through in a big spot. Good extension on that swing. Took the pitch on the outside part of the plate and drove it up the middle. He let it travel just enough.
Jordan Walker next up for the Cardinals. Two outs. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. The pitch. Swing and a drive deep right field. Way back there. And it hits the fence. Here comes Goldie around third. The relay to the plate. He's safe.
He was all over that one. He really let that ball travel on the outside part of the plate, but that's a great example that you can still drive the baseball that's away. Rip that one down the line for the double.
So a man aboard. And the batter will be the shortstop, Mason Wynn. Wouldn't chase that time. Man on second, two down. That one misses. And now 3-1. Here comes a pitch. And that one off the inside edge. You walked him.
The batter. The second baseman.
Nolan Gorman digs in now. Two on, two outs.
Oh, that's off the plate.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
And the right-hander deals. Swing and a ground ball off the middle. That's a base hit. Coming home. He'll score easily. It's 3-0.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So a nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit.
Michael Ciani, the next to hit. Just missed. Close one, doesn't get the call. And now 3-1. The Cards trying to break this one open. Top half of inning number 4. And that's in there at the knees. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. The kick, the 3-2. Swing, and that ball smashed out of line. Hops over the wall, and that's an automatic double. And one comes in on the play.
Well, everyone is thinking, Ed, would the runner have scored from first if the ball stayed in the park? We'll never know, but they do get a run across with a chance to do more damage in the inning.
So the batting order turns over. Now a chance for Brendan Donovan. At the belt and fires. Off the mark there. And a count 2-1. The pitch. Ah. And a full count now. On the ground, right side. Tosses to first. That'll end the inning after a lot of scoring. So nine batters come to the plate. Four of them score. And midway in the fourth, it's the Cardinals 4 and the Tigers nothing. Bottom four, and now the first baseman, Spencer Torkelson.
The first baseman, Spencer Torkelson.
Comes up empty. That's strike
one ball, two.
Two
strikes.
And another ball. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way. That time, a little anxious.
Here's the third baseman, Matt Vierling. The wind of the pitch. And that's a base hit. So the man aboard now with one away.
Now was on time and blew it in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
Man at first. And up next for Detroit, Colt Keith.
He's going.
The kick and the pitch. Runner goes. The 1-1 is fouled off. And the pitch. Towards first, Goldie. And no throw for some reason as he reaches first. That's got to be an error.
Parker Meadow.
And next up for the Tigers, Parker Meadows. Two on, one out.
Hey!
Here's an opportunity. If you're going to get back in this game, you have to take advantage of this situation. This feels like their chance.
The 1-2. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. Picks up strikeout number 7.
Quite the start to this game on the mound. Looking very dangerous to these hitters. 7 punchouts already. So this lineup hasn't had much success trying to figure him out. I'm impressed with what we're seeing here.
So first and second with two outs. Javier Baez up now for the Tigers. Foul ball there. First and second, two down. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. On the ground. Over to Goldie. Baez gone on the play. And that'll do it. Tigers strand a pair. They're down 4-0. We're back, and there's a new arm on the mound to start the fifth. Joey Wentz.
Well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
Wilson. Contreras.
And a pitch. And he grounds one back up the middle. No throw. He's safe at first.
Up next for the Cardinals, the designated hitter, Lars Newbar.
So, man aboard, Lars Newbar. Next up for the Cardinals, So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Contreras on at first, nobody out. And that just misses. Left-hand hitter waits. And down on strikes. And one out now.
Now that out.
Nolan Arenado will hit next. Arenado. When you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy is at the top of the list. And now the lefty. Here's a rocket out to left. Drops in for a hit. Couldn't run it down. Cut off, throw to second. Not in time. It's a double.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
So one out with two aboard. And here's the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt. Two on, one out.
Paul. We got two balls, one strike.
The 2-1. And a foul ball. Second and third, one away. And we're at the top of the fifth. Bounce to the left side. Veerling. Over to first. Now two away as they get a run across.
The right fielder, number 18, Jordan Walker.
Jordan Walker next up for the Cardinals. Runner at second, two down. Next pitch is outside. Man at second. And a foul ball. And here's a 3-2. Popped up to the left. Into foul ground. Veerling drifts towards it. And a foul ball. Two outs. And they'll do it again. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. The pitch. Got it. That ends the inning, and they limit the damage. One run, a pair of hits, no errors, and one left on. Last half of the fifth coming up. It's the Cardinals 5 and the Tigers nothing. Back here in Detroit, and now the catcher comes up to hit. Jake Rogers.
For the Tigers, the catcher.
The wind to kick the pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And a pitch. Wouldn't chase that time. Double barreled action in the bullpen. Andrew Kittredge getting ready to go. Thompson also getting ready. The 2-2. Stays alive. Kicks and deals. Wynn. Jump throw across his body. One up, one down.
The right fielder, number 31, Riley Green.
Riley Green now at the plate. And he deals. Foul ball. Goes down looking.
Well, I'm not really sure why he let that one go by. I mean, out of the hand, it had a lot of the strike zone. Sure, it had some good arm side run at the end to move to the outside part of the plate. But with two strikes, you got to be ready to swing it there, and you can't leave it in the umpire's hands.
And next to hit for Detroit, Mark Canna. And the slider just misses.
Two balls, one strike.
This one high in the air to left center. In position. Drops into the glove. And that'll do it. Back at Comerica Park. Top of the sixth inning. Now it's the shortstop. Mason Wynn.
Wynn.
And he lays down a bunt, and that's just foul. The wind and the pitch. Battling here as he fouls it away. Kicks and fires. Swings and misses. Pulled the string on the changeup.
Up next to the card.
Here's a big power threat. Nolan Gorman.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely, try to hit the ball out of the park, do what he loves to do.
And that one fouled off. Base is empty, one away, and we're in the top half of the sixth. The next offering misses, and it's 2-2. Good job to fight that one off. The pitch.
We got a full count.
Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Veerling drifts towards it. He's got it. And there's two down.
Now back, the center fielder, Michael Ciani.
And now here's a speed threat, outfielder Michael Ciani. Two down, nobody on. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Two outs. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. The lefty fires. Fights that one away, still 1-2. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. The 1-2. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Here's a 1-2. Now a fly ball to right center. Green going after it. And that is that. And we're back. And now the DH, Kerry Carpenter. Righty delivers. Action in the St. Louis bullpen. Andrew Kittredge up and throwing. Left-hand batter waits. Now this is in the air down the line. Walker settles under. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And there's one away.
The batter. The first baseman.
So digging in, Spencer Torkelson.
Torkelson.
The Redbirds leading by five here in the bottom of the sixth. High in the air, out to right. Walker hauls it in, two away.
Now batting, third baseman.
So up next, Matt Vierling. This one smacked out to left center. Tracks it down for the out. That is the inning. Down in order go the Tigers. Still looking at that 5-0 deficit. We go to the top of the seventh. Now the left fielder, Brendan Donovan. Ball and a strike.
One ball, two strikes.
The wind of the pitch. Oh, he doesn't get the call. And the count's even at two. Tigers bullpen with some action. Shelby Miller getting loose for A.J. Hinch. Chafin warming up as well. Two and two. Base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Well, that was one of those high-percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Man at first. In the air, out towards left center. That skips over the fence, so it's an automatic double.
The automatic double took that decision out of the hands of the third base coach, didn't it? I mean, was he planning to send him home? We don't know, maybe, but now he's preparing for a whole different situation with a pair of runners in scoring position.
And next is the designated hitter, Lars Nootbaar. And another ball. Donovan on third. Contreras at second with nobody out. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Base hit. One run is in. Another comes in to score. It's 7-0.
Big one there as he drives in a couple of runs. These days, most outfielders play pretty deep, and I'm not sure if that was a factor there or not, but off the bat, you're thinking it's going to be a pop-out, and it just kind of nestled into that spot where no one was able to get to it.
A new arm into the game, the righty, Alex Fiedo.
And with the big deficit on the scoreboard, he almost has to just put that out of his mind. Every outing matters for relievers and their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game.
And next is the Cardinals four hitter, Nolan Arenado. The pitch. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. And here it comes. Fouls it off, still 1-2. Slider misses outside. Two runs across in the inning. Here in the top half of inning number seven. And that one is in the dirt. And that's ball three. And he grounds one to the right side. And that one finds its way through. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
How about just a simple ground ball the other way. And it had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
Here's Paul Goldschmidt. Right-hander kicks, deals. That one hammered center field. That's back there. And it's gone. And they tack on three. It's 10-0.
Those are the at-bats that leave pitchers exhausted. He had to throw a lot of pitches and still gave up the long ball. That's a bad combo. A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
Jordan Walker digs in now. And a swing and a line drive at a right field. Green brings it in. And there's one down.
Up next to the Cardinals, the shortstop, Mason.
Here's the shortstop at the play. Mason Wynn. The 1-1 is fouled off. One down, base is empty. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Bounced out to short, Baez. Just got him on that one.
Well, he's one of the best shortstops in the sport, no doubt about it. And he put his skills on display once again right there. Great stop on the backhand, but it was the transfer and throw for me that really stood out. The speed going down the line, there's no way he gets the out any other way. That was impressive.
Breaks his bat, pops it up. On to first. And they're happy to just get off the field after that frame. Goldie goes yard for the Cards. It's now 10-0. It's Major League Baseball on the show. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Matthew Liberatore.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
Colt Keith leading getting up. Ready to hit.
The second baseman. Colt Keith.
Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
And another ball. Two now. Arenado to first in time and one away in the bottom of the seventh.
Center fielder Parker Meadows.
Here's the center fielder Parker Meadows. The Tigers with a lot of ground to make up here at the bottom of the seventh. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And there's a ball. The punch out there. Now two away.
Just a mid-90s challenge fastball right there. Not much to it. And I'm sure he'd love another swing at it because it was in a very hittable location. Those are the swings where you sometimes start to question yourself as a hitter and say, how did I miss that? But you know what happens.
Downstairs, and it misses ball four.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter. But he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
Baez, the runner at first with two gone. On the corner for a strike, and the count is 1-2.
One ball, two strikes.
And that's outside. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. One left for Detroit. Not looking good. They're down 10-0. New inning getting started. Now up for St. Louis, Michael Ciani.
Nope, that's a ball.
The 2-1. Swing and a foul straight back. And a pitch.
I got 3-2.
That one hit to right. And there's one down.
The left fielder, number 33, Brendan Donovan.
And here's the St. Louis leadoff man, Brendan Donovan. One down, base is empty.
Nope. Two balls, one strike.
And the righty deals. Out to short, Baez. Whips it across, and that's an out.
Well, Bird, we talked about how the ball is coming out of the pitcher's hand. The way it comes out of his hand as an infielder, wow, really impressive.
Wilson Contreras, next up for the Cardinals. 2-2 now.
Three balls, two strikes.
The pitch. And miss, struck him out, and it's a three up, three down inning. 1-2-3 go to Cardinals, but they're still in front 10-0. Bottom of the inning, and here's the Tiger leadoff man, Riley Green. This one lifted in the air, left field. Donovan makes the catch, and there's one down.
Now got left fielder, Mark Canna.
Mark Canna up now for the Tigers. The 1-1. That one back up the middle, and it gets through. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Just kept it simple. Blake Pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there was just no one there to knock it down.
Kerry Carpenter up now for the Tigers. Up and in. Now two balls and a strike. Man at first, one away. Fouls one off. 2-2. Here comes a pitch. That just misses. Three balls, two strikes. And there's ball
that's
four.
Ball four. Take your base.
Well, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Spencer Torkelson. Canna over at second, Carpenter over at first, so going away. That's out to center field. Ciani sizes this one up. Ciani snags it. So first and second with two outs. Matt Veerling up now for the Tigers. Two on, two outs.
A 1-2 count. All he's seen is fastballs. You've got to expect something off speed. Stay back.
The pitch. And another ball activity in the bullpen. Andrew Kittredge, the hard-throwing righty, is up and loosening. Number 64 getting loose as well. Wouldn't chase that time. The Cardinals up big in this one here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. Donovan makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Tigers strand a pair. They're down 10-0. Back here in Detroit, and now Lars Nootbaar.
Lars Nootbaar.
And the right-hander deals. And that one in the air center field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One up, one down.
Up next for the Cardinals, the third baseman, Nolan.
And up next for St. Louis, Nolan Arenado. One down, base is empty.
2-1.
The 2-1. On the inside corner for a strike.
That ball is foul.
The wind of the pitch. That one is absolutely belted. And in one hops the wall. Around first, digging for two. Not in time. He's safe.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
So digging in, Paul Goldschmidt. Swings through that one for strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. And the pitch. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count.
Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off speed to the fastball, and the hitter doesn't know what's coming next.
Man at second.
2-2 to count.
In the dirt, blocked. No advance. Good job behind the dish. Two two now. Three. And down on strikes he goes. Two down.
Bogey just ran out of patience there. He took a couple of pitches to even that count up at two balls and two strikes, but that time chased outside the zone.
Jordan Walker next up for the Cardinals. High fly ball out to center field. Meadows has a beat on it. Makes the play, and it's out number three. No runs, one hit, no errors, and a man left. 6-7-8 scheduled to start the bottom of the ninth. It's the Redbirds 10 and the Tigers nothing. Bottom nine. Now it's the second baseman, Colt Keith.
The second baseman.
The pitch. Late with the swing there.
One ball, two strikes.
Goes down swinging for the strikeout. Had him out front for strike three. And up next for Detroit, Parker Meadows.
The center fielder. Parker Meadows.
And now the lefty. That one fouled off. In the air right field, sizing this one up. Snags it for the second out.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive him.
So they're down to their final out. The batter now, Javier Baez. Kicks and deals.
That's in. Ball two.
Pitch misses. Three and one.
Three balls, one strike.
And a pitch. They're down to their final strike.
Helpful.
Liberatore is just one strike away. Right through there. Got him. Ball game.
Well, I'm not sure if he expected to get nine outs in this one, but he had the gas in the tank to get it done. Kind of a throwback save for this guy today, but helps the team get the win. As you can see, they're pretty happy about it, and they're celebrating his performance in this one.
10-0, your final in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
Our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious St. Louis Cardinals, 10 runs on 14 hits.